The topic is existence of a unique solution to a first order initial value problem. So here's a good review from Calc 3. A polynomial, looking at the definition right here, a polynomial function of two variables is a sum of terms of the form cxmyn. C is a constant and mn are non-negative integers. So here's an example of a function that's a polynomial. Now, what's a rational function? A rational function has this form, f of x, y, it's a rational function. A polynomial divided by a polynomial will give you a rational function. So here's an example of a rational function, polynomial over a polynomial. Now, what do we mean with a function of two variables continuous at a point a, b? We mean the limit of f of x, y as the x, y approaches a point a, b is equal to f of a, b. What do we mean with a function continuous on a region D? It just means that it's continuous at every point a, b in that region. And what does that mean? It just means the surface has no hall or break. Now, what else we need to know? We need to know that all polynomials are continuous on R squared, means on the whole plane, xy plane. R squared means xy plane. And also, rational functions are continuous on their domain. And also, the composite functions are continuous on their domain. All right, so let's do the first example. First, you need to know what the existence and uniqueness theorem is right here. Let R be a rectangular region in the xy plane. X is between A and B. C is between Y is between C and D. In other words, let me just do it here. So what we're saying is X is between A and B, right? This is X. C is between C and D. So here's the region. We're talking about this R. And it contains x0, y0 is right there, right here, anywhere. Now, it says if f of x, y, we're looking at this dE, if f of x, y, this is what we mean with this, and its partial derivative are continuous on R, then we know there exists an I0 containing AB. There is an I0 here, such that there's going to be a unique function. So let's assume it's right here, function y, and this is x0, y0. That is a solution to the initial value problem right there, and this initial condition y of x0 equal y0. All right, so let's do example one. Determine a region of the xy plane for which dy dx is equal to y to the 2/3 would have a unique solution whose graph passes through a point x0, y0 in that region. Alright, so first thing, we're trying to use the theorem. So first thing, we need to know what f of xy is. I mean, if you look at it, whatever is on your right side is f of xy. So in our case, this is f of xy. So f of xy is equal y 2 over 3. And then we also need to calculate partial of f, right there, partial of f with respect to y. Of course, partial of f with respect to y is going to be 2 over 3y. 2 over 3 minus 1 is negative 1/3. This is the same thing as 2 over 3 cube root of y, and if I want to rewrite this, this is going to be cube root of y squared, right? So the domain of f, for f, we're looking for all the xy's such that we want y, it's continuous everywhere. Y can be anything. So the domain for this one will be, the domain for just f of xy will be r squared. In other words, all the point xy's. For partial of f with respect to I, if we think of this as a function, the domain is anything, y cannot be zero, right? So, in other words, we can say that the region we're looking for is any rectangular region. Remember, we're supposed to determine a region, any rectangular region. Such that y is not equal to zero. As long as y is not equal to zero, we're okay. All right, let's do the next example. Same thing. This is example 2, dy dx is equal to square root of xy. So this is going to be f of xy, right? So f of xy is continuous on its domain. In other words, you want x, what's the domain? Let me write it here. Domain would be all the xy's such that xy is bigger or equal than zero. Right? You want the inside, whatever under radical, to be bigger or equal than zero, which means you want x and y to have the same sign, x positive and y positive, bigger or equal than zero. Or x less or equal than zero and y is less or equal than zero. Now let's do partial f with respect to y. Remember, f of xy is the same thing, okay, let me write it this way. That's the same thing as xy 1/2. So using the chain rule, 1/2 xy, 1/2 minus 1 is negative 1/2 times the partial with respect to y of the inside will be x, which means this is x over 2 square root of xy, right? So the domain for the partial of f with respect to y, in other words, we want whatever inside the radical not to be zero, right? We want xy strictly positive, right? So in other words, the answer will be any region such that, right? If you do the intersection of both of these, that would be x has to be strictly bigger than zero and y strictly bigger than zero, or x is less strictly than zero and y is less than zero. So they have to be the same sign. Not only that, they cannot be zero because you don't want the denominator to be zero. Now, example 3 is a little bit tricky. F of xy is not y. Actually, you have to write it in this form. Dy dx has to be on the left side. In other words, we need to divide by x. So dy dx is equal y over x. Now this is going to be my f of xy. So it's a little bit tricky. You got to watch. You need to get rid of dx before you can see what is f of xy. What do we know? The domain of f of xy would be all the xy's such that x is not equal to zero. Right? Now we need to do partial of f with respect to y and see where it's continuous. So we know f of xy is continuous at any region where x is not equal to zero. And then partial of f with respect to y is equal what? I will just write, let me do this. I write it this way, partial of y Right, this is 1 over x times y. So 1 over x is just a constant, so this is going to be 1 over x. So same thing, you don't want x to be 0. So the answer will be, we have a unique, there exists a unique solution on any rectangular region where x is not equal 0. In other words, right there, that's the set. Alright, more examples. Dy over dx minus y is equal x. Same thing here, we need to get rid of this negative y, so I'm going to write it on the right side. Now, we know this is a polynomial, so continuous on R square, in other words, any plane, on the entire plane. Now, this is my f of xy, right? Now, partial of f with respect to y is going to be equal to what? 0 plus derivative of y is 1, so it's equal 1. So, therefore, the answer will be any region in R squared. In other words, on any region in R squared on the plane, on XY plane. R squared means XY plane. Alright, number 5. Again, we need to get rid of 4 minus y squared. So y prime is equal x squared over 4 minus y squared, which is f of xy. Now, what's the domain of f of xy? It's all the xy's such that 4 minus y squared, the Russian functions, this cannot be 0, which means y squared cannot be 4, y cannot be minus or plus 2. Now, we need to do partial of f with respect to y. We have to use quotient rule. So partial of x squared with respect to y is 0 times the denominator minus partial with respect to y of 4 minus y squared will be minus 2y times numerator, which is x squared, divided by the denominator squared. That's the quotient rule. So partial of f with respect to y, 0 minus minus is plus, so it's 2x squared y over 4 minus y squared squared. So what's the domain for this function, partial f with respect to y? You want all the xy's such that 4 minus y squared cannot be 0, which means this cannot be 0. So again, same thing, you don't want minus 2, minus and plus 2. In other words, the answer will be, there will be unique solution, let me write this nice, to this equation, 4 minus y squared, y prime equal x squared, in any rectangular region such that y is less than 0 or y is between negative 2, or y is bigger than 2. And that's it for this example.